Sisters and brothers in Christ, on the back of the United States of America, we find this amazing declaration: in God we trust. In today's gospel, Jesus our Lord strongly urges us to put our trust in God's love and care. The question is whether these are two identical statements or they may contain certain differences, even they are fundamentally in sharp contrast. Let us start from the very top of the American society. Father Richard Rohr, a well-known American Franciscan theologian, wrote in his book entitled Trial and the Mystery of Suffering. This is his quote. The church in the West has looked at the gospel and history from that superior position for more than 1600 years. We became not the church of the poor. At our best, we were the church for the poor. From our privileged position of the rich, we became a middle class and even upper middle class church that largely opposed much that Jesus preached about riches and wealth. The church saw no problem, as most Christians see no problem today, with being fabulously wealthy, amassing huge securities and insurance and properties, and still believing that we trust in God. End the quote. The world in general, and the church in the West in particular, have achieved a living standard high enough, secure enough, that the citation of Jesus' words, "In God we trust," has little to do with what the good news message really wants us to listen and to live today. In particular, Christians who in other parts of the developing world only find out that they do not stand on the same social, economic, cultural, and political platform. In God we trust, from the mouth of the wealthy and powerful, sounds very close and similar to what was uttered by the Pharisee who was raising God, or rather he was raising himself for his privileged life, much better than and superior to that of the tax collector, the rest in society. Oh God, I thank you that I'm not like the rest of humanity, greedy, dishonest, adulterous, or even like these tax collectors. I fast twice a week, and I pay tithe on my own income. In God we trust from the mouth of those who trust in banks, millions of dollars, with printed "In God we trust" appears seemingly tantamount to a holier than down attitude. "In God we trust" preached by Jesus means that we human beings aware of our humble and weak nature in life, just like the white flowers growing in the morning and fading in the evening. Put all our hopes and dreams in God, our Heavenly Father, who loves and cares for each one of us, his children, more and better than our parents do us. In God we trust us more profound, when it is proudly proclaimed by Christians in times of extremely hard challenges and persecutions. When not because of your own fault you are jobless, you are barred from taking part in the building and defense of your own society. In God we trust results as shaking as 9.9 Richter earthquake. When you speak it out without a second thought, in the darkness of suffering and loneliness, and when you have 1,000 times cried out to God for help, but not even a yes or no could be heard from above. In God the child becomes undeniably as great as a progression of faith in the faithful God who always keeps his promises, even with so high a cost, dark of the blood of his only begotten Son. In God the trust remains forever the love song, lovely offered to the loving and caring God by children with grateful heart along the way of this pilgrimage on earth, leading to the heavenly home prepared for them from eternity. In God we trust, St. Paul also encouraged us to say it again and again when he writes in his letter to the Romans. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed to us. Amen.